So with this lesson, we're going to learn a little bit more about Photoshop brushes. By default, the brushes that we have access to in Photoshop are going to be pretty basic and usually something like a circle brush. And that may limit you from the types of things you can paint and create in Photoshop. So with that said, before we learn how to create custom brushes, we're going to learn how to access brushes created by other creatives. And so you can do just a quick search through Google for free Photoshop brushes. You'll find a ton of resources. Most of these are free. Keep in mind, a lot of these websites do hope to encourage subscriptions or purchases. So some of them may encourage a donation or a purchase. So keep that in mind as you download brushes. And then when you do download them, they usually download as an ABR file. And now this ABR file is something very unique to Photoshop. Once we're back in Photoshop, we can basically activate this brush tool, go to our brush panel, and right here at this sprocket wheel, we can choose to do what's called importing brushes. Okay, in older versions of Photoshop, they called it loading brushes. This is the new option for you. If you've been using Photoshop for a while, the new option is called import brushes. And so basically, we're going to go find the brushes that we've been using or that we've accessed and downloaded. And then we'll just basically select one and then say open. Once we do that, you will notice a folder pop up in your brush panel. And this folder is a new brush set or a new brush group that we now have access to. So all of these different brushes, you now have access so that you can use them. And we're going to see if we can have one that has a little bit more detail. You may or may not see this. This is a grunge brush, so let's see what happens. So as I paint, it's very subtle. Now I'll go through that process one more time and we'll see if we can find another brush that's a little easier for you to see. So we'll go through import brushes and let's choose paint lines. So again, there's another group that just popped up. Now we can use any of these. So now as we choose to paint, you can see the preview of the brush. You can also see right here where it says 2,387. That is the pixel dimensions this brush was created at. So this is a very high resolution brush for you to use. And at any point, you're going to be able to paint and create some fun stuff. Now, when you have custom brushes, they're usually a little bit more unique, so that option to be able to rotate this brush up in the options panel, this is a good example of being able to move the position of this brush. Let's get that brush back. And then we have it in a different position. So just know that that is a good option to remember when you start loading in custom brushes. You can rotate them. So we've got all these different brushes. As you click on each one, if you notice these pixel dimensions, the default value that's popping up, that is the pixel dimension that they are created at. Now, if we start looking at some of these other brushes, that one's a pretty high resolution brush. Some of these other ones here, this one is only 381 pixels. So that means it's going to be a lot smaller. So as you load in custom brushes, you do want to keep in mind that if it was created at a smaller resolution, you do want to make sure that you do not increase the scale of it. If we start increasing the scale tremendously, and I'll overlap that painting there, you start to notice that we're losing quality. So it starts to look a little bit more pixelated, a little bit more blurry. So just keep in mind, if you do decide to download brushes from another source, you want to make sure you pay attention to this size right here. So right now it's saying it's 1300, but we've already verified that by default it came in at a much smaller size. So just keep in mind that, you know, Photoshop's going to let you go up and down in size, but it doesn't mean it's going to make a better quality brush, a lot like changing the size of images. Okay. As we go through, you may end up loading a ton of brushes, and this is where I have to tell you that it can become very addictive. And as you load all of these brushes, you may start to notice that Photoshop starts to run a little bit slower. And if it does, my best encouragement to you is to keep your ABR file saved somewhere on your computer, because Photoshop does load them into its memory. And so if you have, you know, 500 loaded and Photoshop starts to slow down, you may actually want to remove some of these. So what we'll do is we'll select a couple, and then we'll just go through this process right here, this process to delete groups. Now, this will actually delete them from your Photoshop. So as long as you have that ABR file, you can reload it at any point. Okay. Now, if you have a brush that you had made and you want to save it, that's where you might export instead, which we'll go through that process in another lesson when we learn to create custom brushes. But we can choose delete groups and then say okay, and then it's gone. And again, if you have that brush at any point, we can bring it back just by reloading it. So we can just go back through that process, and there they are again. So that ABR file is that really important file that we're going to want, so that you can use that brush in any Photoshop program that you decide to work in, and that you can load it and unload it as needed.